Dickinson begins one of her poems with, "Because I could not stop for death, he kindly stopped for me. The carriage held but just ourselves and immortality." Many of her poems do deal with death, and we find then that this is a common topic for poetry in general, not just Dickinson's poetry. But we deal with death and we deal with love, the two most common human emotions. Certainly there are poems about other things, but these, you'll find, are two dominating ideas within the field of poetry. As you read through Dickinson's poems, you will find a great many that do in fact deal with death. And this is a very common topic for her. You'll find also that she is a bit of a traditionalist when compared to Whitman. She does sometimes use rhymes, she does often use meter, but she does not use it in an absolutely uniform fashion. Certainly she knew how to use it, but she does not always feel obligated to use it, even though she knew certainly how. So you'll find this as a recurring method of writing in her poetry, often using meter, what we call hymn meter sometimes. The hymn meter that Dickinson uses in many of her poems comes from the old hymns that the Puritans and others used and actually sung in churches. And she picked up on this form and actually incorporated it into many of her poems. She does not use it in all of them, of course, but you will find it used very often in her poetry. Dickinson is an unusual character also in that she was never really an established or published poet, particularly in her own time. She was an unknown. And when she died, they went out and cleaned her effects up, cleaned out her house and the room. Her relatives came across these boxes full of poems. Poems just written on little scraps of paper and bundled together. And we're very fortunate that these all didn't just get thrown out into a fire somewhere. But they knew that she dabbled in poetry and wrote it, and they saved these then. And they were passed on to someone who knew what to do with them. And so we have discovered a major poet writing in the midst of the 1800s that could easily have been lost. Well, Dickinson is a very innovative poet in her own way, and certainly one of our most outstanding poets for this period of time. So read her carefully. She does warrant that, but I think you'll also find that she has something to communicate in most of her poems that we can understand, and it's something that's very worthwhile as well. Enjoy her.